You're losing focus, kid. I warned you about that.
How could this place exist? I don't understand. What's happening in here?
Ruvik knows you're here. He's feeding off you. But there are more important problems. That detective.
Joseph isn't something to worry about. He doesn't suspect anything.
He's expendable. How else do you want me to say it? Remove him. That's an order.
Kevin, what are you doing?
Killing Joseph? That's not gonna help me find Leslie.
Come on, I can get some help.
He can't be trusted. He'll turn on you. They all will, once they know what you're after. We told you. You're weak, kid. And you're disappointing us.
Are you guys all right?
We're all right. Sebastian, maybe we can lift this enough for Kidman to go under and open it from the other side.
We're counting on you.
It's odd, though. Why would they catch you instead of just killing you?
Maybe he didn't see me as a threat.
He?
I know who you are. I'm not going to let you take him. You should have followed your orders, kid.
That brought us here. I'll kill you for that. Think I'm stupid, Kidman? You're the one that brought us here! I'll kill you for that!
Why are you making me do this? Damn it, Joseph! You should have just stayed out of the way!
Are there sins you are ashamed of?
Wait a second. This house... No, it can't be.
Hidden.
Mother would sit in her chair, rocking back and forth, killing time until the next service. She barely spent any time.
Miss Kidman, please tell me about your family.
Next subject. Thus, I wondered why she even had children at all.
Kidman, Julie, you've assembled quite the resume, I see.
They taught you to read.
Kidman, Julie, you've assembled quite the resume, I see.
They taught you to read at the police academy? I'm impressed.
Your attitude won't be necessary today.
What is this place? Why am I here?
You've been arrested, Miss Kidman, and you're currently being detained. I'm sure even you could decipher that.
That's not what I asked. This isn't a regular interrogation room. They don't give you cushy chairs when you're about to be sent to lockup.
No current address. On your own since 14, a runaway it seems. Quite impressive you've made it this long without coming to your senses. If your street smarts are that keen, I'd imagine you'd have turned yourself around by now.
It's more about survival. You think I'm pissed I got caught? At least I get free food in jail. It's all good to me.
What if I told you that today could be different for you? You're a smart kid, you've got nothing to lose, no one to miss you. A person with those qualities could be open to very specific opportunities.
What are you saying? You offering me a get out of jail free card or something?
Not quite that, but something close.
I'm listening.
Miss Kidman, please tell me about your family.
Next subject.
No. We've prolonged this talk for a while now. It's important for our understanding of you.
They never gave a shit. Too caught up in that church of theirs. More like a cult. It was like a punishment. Nothing I ever did was good enough for them.
They abused you?
No. It was more like neglect. That's why when I just left, they didn't care. They never came looking, they just gave up.
And you never went back to them?
I did. A couple of years later, they were gone. Everyone was gone. It was like the whole town got up and moved. I should have felt something, but I didn't.
And how do you feel about it now?
The same. They can rot for all I care. It was strange, though. There's a statue in the center of town, an angel with its head in its hands. I used to just stare at it when I was young, thinking it was sad. But now, I felt like even that statue knew how pitiful life was there. What a terrible place.
Leslie! Leslie, stop!
At night, I would stare up at the statue lit up in the center of town. It looked like it was crying for all the wasted life in that place. Of my past. STEM must be creating this.
In life, we constantly search for a place we feel safe. A home we can always come back to. We imagine that place in our minds and are drawn to it. You had a home, but now that place is here with us.
Reuben has no idea what he's done. I'm afraid that the fragile mental states of the subjects are limiting our studies. Mobius wants us to move past Beacon patients and onto more stable people. They want to get STEM closer to its intended use. Would they see the world in the same way? Would a sane mind weather the psychically draining experience? I had that dream again. I entered the STEM myself. I'm afraid that the fragile mental states of the subjects are limiting our studies. Mobius wants us to move past Beacon patients and onto more stable people. They want to get STEM closer to its intended use. Would they see the world in the same way? Would a sane mind weather the psychically draining experience? I had that dream again. I entered the STEM myself.
Mm-hmm.